feeling a big game tonight, kid.
Hey, MP, I got some film I want you to watch.
But the last time you faced him, you see what happened right here?
Yeah, we made the play.
No, watch it again. See how he's a step slow on the rotation?
Yeah. I missed that.
I'm sure he didn't. That's not a mistake he usually makes. You don't count on him making it again. You want to get another win against these guys? You're gonna have to...
I gotta clean that up.
Yeah, exactly. And then take a look at this one. Same thing. Right here. Watch.
Yep.
Little slow.
That's my bad, coach.
They say you got a tough matchup today. I say you got it.
Good evening and welcome to tonight's presentation of Noche La NBA, an annual tradition in the NBA celebrating diversity and culture, and always a pleasure to bring it to you. This is Kevin Harlan along courtside with Brett Berry and Greg Anthony. We've got David Aldridge on our sideline. And a look at the starters for the Cavaliers. The wing set for Mitchell and Okoro. Then there's Allen. Then there's Garland. And for Phoenix, a loaded front court with Durant and Ayton at the 4 and 5, respectively. Bradley Beal is out there with Fleming, and it's Harrington in at the small forward. Hey, Greg, what are you looking for here as they enter their first night of a back-to-back?
We'll see how the coaching staff distributes minutes among the players. You don't want to overuse your guys tonight and leave them sluggish for tomorrow. It's about finding a balance.
So Phoenix will get the first possession. A key matchup tonight is the one between MP and Darius Garland. MP got the win in the first meeting, and he's looking to repeat that success tonight.
Definitely going to be interesting to see how MP has prepared and gets established offensively and defensively early on.
And Greg, you talk about rim protection. Cleveland can really shut down the lane, can't they?
Yeah, I mean, they have the personnel to do it. Big front court and quick guards who can keep ball handlers in front of them.
Free throw good, MP.
Well, not just a fantastic basketball player, MP also a great example for all the youngsters out there off the floor.
And both free throws good for MP. Now Garland. He dishes it to Allen. Garland against MP. There's Allen. That's good on the assist by Garland.
And Allen not bothered at all from that little bit of contact.
Garland against MP. Ayton a screen on Garland. MP passes to Ayton. And Ayton throws it down.
Not getting old here. Seeing him make that lead pass with perfect timing.
Game for the Cavaliers. It was a loss to the Warriors. Passes to Garland. Allen at the screen for Garland. No good from outside. MP against Garland. KD a screen on Garland. Fleming the pass to KD. Nice fake, but the layup off the mark. It's Garland with the ball for the Cavaliers. Allen outside. There's the triple. And that's good. Darius Garland for three.
3-point field.
You always wonder about those bigger guys, how much easier a read is like that. And Allen finds the open guy set up to shoot it.
MP deciding where to go with it. Here's Durant. Good, and it's MP picking up the assist.
And hitting the mid-range jumper here early gives the defense just another thing to think about.
Yeah, he's got to be a little bit more on their radar after knocking down something like that.
Launches a three. No good. The Suns have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Durant for three. Rebound by Mitchell.
He's not the guy that you want to give a wide open look from 3-point range. They're lucky that that one doesn't cost them.
With Samart and Garland with the lay-in.
Assist.
Garland's got five.
Donovan Mitchell.
Pretty silky smooth floater from Garland that time.
Garland against MP. Ayton sets the pick for MP. It's good.
That play never gets old. The pick and roll will still be an offensive staple 100 years from now. Trust me.
Garland with it. 5 points in the game. Takes a three. Another miss by Garland.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay.
Harrington kicks to MP.
2 minutes remaining in the first.
Durant with a screen on Garland. Stolen by Allen. And now Okoro running the floor all by himself. Now here's Mitchell. Last game he had 28 points. Gurevic. Those three-pointers off the mark. So for Phoenix, their last game a win against Boston. MP against Garland. Inside. Shots good by Durant. KD's got his second bucket of the night.
Not fair of a coach to send out one defender against Kevin Durant, skilled at fighting through whatever challenges the D wants to throw at him.
Now, here's Mitchell. No scoring in this one. Outside Garland. Back to Mitchell. Down to five on the shot clock. A three ball. Harrington with the rebound. Suns lead by three. Outside, KD. It's in. That's his third field goal of the game. He's 3-for-5.
Now that basket must be widening out right now. He's making almost every shot he's putting up this quarter.
Allen with the screen for Mitchell. Here's the pass to Okoro. To the middle. Some solid defense from Ayton.
Well, a lot of players in the league are going to make that shot, and for him, it's pretty much automatic. It's a good defensive effort to prevent the layup.
Now, here's MP. He's certainly been a consistent piece of their offense, averaging about 14 and a half points a game. And here is Garland. Mitchell outside. They set the pick. Can they get it? Doesn't get it to drop for him. And that does it for the first quarter. Suns lead by 5. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number 2. Welcome back, everyone, to the second quarter of play here on Noche Latina. Vámonos. And a moment now to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for Phoenix.
And, guys, they've done a great job feeding their bigs inside. They are just punishing the opposition in the paint.
Let's make sure that that selfish nerve doesn't get tapped, because right now there's great ball movement. They're setting each other up. Let's see if that maintains.
Lee out there with Bradley Beal. And it's best in its center. So that's the lineup on the floor for the Suns. Talking about Bradley Beal, Greg, I feel like he doesn't get enough credit for his passing game.
You know, Kevin, he's really evolved as a playmaker over the years. Sure, we all know how talented a scorer and shooter he is, but Bradley is now superb at facilitating. And it's coming easy for them right now. 5 baskets in a row in the paint.
Here's Jerome. He's covered by Beal. Jerome passes to Allen. Pass to LeVert for the 3. Still looking for his first make after that miss. He's 0 for 2. Right now, let's send it over to the sidelines and get a report from David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Jared Allen is earning his keep in the painted area. He said from a young age that was instilled in him. Footwork as a big, back to the basket. I'm trying to find it in the flow of the offense. I don't want to disrupt us to where I'm getting in people's way. I just want to find my spot. Kevin?
And he does it well. D.A., thank you. Now, here's LeVert. Still without a basket. Over Lee. No good off the back of the rim. Right wing. Pass to Watanabe. Lee dishes to Beal. Lee passes to Watanabe. Suns moving the ball around. The Suns need to get a shot off. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. Look at the last game for the Suns. It was a win against the Celtics in Boston. Right, the pass to Wade. Allen with it. The shot's good on the assist by Wade.
Defense has got to respect that once Allen gets that close, he has that ability to score the ball.
And first time out of the game called for Phoenix. They went to Cleveland for their last meeting with the Cavaliers, and they came out with a win.
And the last time they faced this club, rebounding was their big advantage.
The bank shot, very popular at one time. Brent, what happened to it?
I think the only time you really see it, Kevin, is when guys are going in for layups at full speed and trying to take some of that speed off the basketball. But guys really just don't get the ball in possession where they're going to use a good angle off the glass. Those are usually mid-range shots. How many of those do you see?
Now, here's MP, coming off a stellar performance against Boston. Here's Ayton, and he finishes nicely on the layup. Ayton's got the lead up to 7 now for the Suns.
Another rebound hauled in. They're hitting the glass with a lot of passion.
Here in the second quarter, about 3 minutes played, Garland with the bucket.
And just like last time, it's been great to see these guys clash. They seem pretty evenly matched.
Here's MP. Ayton a screen on Garland. Here's Fleming. Drives to the hoop. Lays it up and banks it in. MP's got 6.
Inside, the defense tries to lock it down, but MP stays pretty cool under that kind of pressure, and he finds a way through it.
Mitchell passes to Allen, and stolen by Ayton. Deal with it. Now defended by Mitchell. And he gets it to go.
Donovan Mitchell.
Mitchell's got his first points of the game.
That's just tremendous scoring instinct. So fun to watch him work in the half court.
Ayton a screen on Garland. Here's MP. Right to the rack. It's MP.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
And so it's Garland who brings up the ball for the Cleveland Cavaliers. They trail by 6. It's up a 3. The kick out to right. No good on the triple. For Phoenix, they've gone 4-7 from the field in this second quarter so far. 35 seconds left to play here in the half. Fleming the pass to KD. Stolen by Okoro. The 3 from Garland. And the 3 ball is good. He's got 11.
Pretty much poor defensive effort there. You have to get a hand in his face when he's spotting up from distance.
And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
First personal foul.
Well, with his scoring ability, MP is a challenging defensive assignment for anybody trying to guard him.
This is his second trip to the free throw line. And he knocks down the first one. Both teams deciding to change it up. And so he's able to get 1 of 2. Now Garland. Gurevich, and he got that one up in time, but doesn't go in.
He keeps adding strength and conditioning through the years. A big help to Kevin Durant there on the defensive end.
And some good action through the first 2 quarters as we reach halftime. The Suns on top, leading by 4. We'll see you after halftime for the beginning of the 3rd quarter.
Hey folks, let's kick this halftime show off by checking out the players of the week. Over in the East, Joel Embiid.
The big man, Joel Embiid, is so patient with his moves and decision making now. His combination of size and feet work are incredible. He has that Hakeem Olajuwon gene. Looking for him to win this award many more times to come.
And time to switch gears. The Suns are in a close one after the first half of play.
Well, they've done a decent job of boxing out, sealing the boards. They're quick to the ball, and they look hungry.
They've obviously made rebounding a priority coming into this one. Mission accomplished so far. And that about wraps it up. And as the 3rd quarter is about to begin, we go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
We We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. You look at Darius Garland. Guys, what a contribution.
Well, through the first two, he has been nothing short of a marksman from deep.
Yeah, you would hope the defense at least would start to consider creeping up on him just a little bit.
And so in the game for the Cavaliers, at the guard position, it's Garland and Mitchell. Then it's Okoro. Then there's Allen. Now, here's Garland. Shot clock at 5. For 3, Mitchell gets it to go from beyond the arc. Mitchell's got it going here in the start of the second half. The first points in the third quarter for Cleveland. It's time now to hear from our Hall of Fame reporter, David Aldridge. What's the latest, David?
Hey, guys. MP, in the last time out against the Celtics, gave his team an edge. He scored 23 points and did a sound job getting the ball to his teammates as well. And it was important for them to break that losing streak. He was a big reason why they were able to do it. Kevin?
David, we appreciate the update. Greg, he was sensational the other night, making play after play after play.
And that's what you want. Not only was the effort there, but how about the production as well?
He can do a lot of different things, so he falls into these different roles. Which will it be tonight?
And so here's Cleveland. Phoenix able to drain the three. Allen with it. He's got 11. Comes up empty down low.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
MP with it, and Allen picks him up defensively.
You know, fought hard from start to finish on that play, defended the shot, and then finished it off with the rebound.
Now, here's Mitchell. 5 points in the game. Over Beal. Second chance shot, and the shot is good. The Phoenix lead has been cut down to just 4 points in the bucket from Allen.
And the coaching staff and this team, they count on Allen for those second chance opportunities, so he collects 2 more.
Here's MP, and blocked. That one goes careening off the glass. Garland against Harrington. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. Allen kicks to Garland. That's tipped. Beal with it. Now defended by Mitchell. And Ayton throws it down.
And Beal continues to be that guy where he opens your eyes with his playmaking.
The Cavaliers trail by 6. So timeout called here. The first for Cleveland.
And coach can't be happy, and I think I know why. Their defense putting up no resistance inside.
No, they're not preventing them from scoring. And if you can get to a high efficiency shot on the floor, and that's the paint, you just keep going.
And Phoenix making a change here. Lee's checked in. And Cleveland with a change here, too. LeVert's checked in. Beal against Garland. Passes it to Allen. Back to Garland. Beal pulls it in. Beal's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
And they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's +5 in that category.
Here's Ayton. It's rebounded by Cleveland. Allen's got his 6th rebound on the night. It's stolen by Harrington. And Phoenix pushing it up now. He can't get that one. Garland with the defensive effort. The Cavaliers trail by 6. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Going inside, and a great assist by Allen as that one goes in.
Jared Allen.
Yeah, Garland did a nice job. Pretty lethal off the bounce and great body control on that drive.
Lee outside. Kicks it to Beal. Ayton a screen. Beal the pass to Ayton. Oh, and the jam by Ayton.
How about Aiden going up there and showing off a little bit of his skill with the half turn?
Mitchell outside. There's the dish to Garland. Shoots the three. Gurevich. Rebound by the Suns. Next up on the docket, the Bucks following this one. They'll find themselves in the middle of this string of three straight at home. Lee finds it. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. Here's Garland, picks one up.
Good idea to make Ayton earn it at the line because he's a menace in the paint. Don't let him get that shot up.
Two shots.
And that one misses.
Well, Ayton and efficiency go hand in hand. I mean, this guy's field goal percentage is on cloud nine.
And he's good on the second. And it's Mitchell with the ball for the Cleveland Cavaliers. 7-point differential. They've got MP. Lee out there with Ayton. And it's Watanabe in at the four. Who's out there for Phoenix. Now MP. Following the 3-point attempt by Donovan Mitchell. They set the pick. Here's Fleming. And Okoro pulls it down. The Cavaliers trail by 7. The pass to LeVert. In the corner, Okoro with it. That's good. And it's LeVert with the assist.
3-point field.
Okoro's got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for Cleveland. MP outside. Ayton a screen on Mitchell. And here's what Cleveland's schedule is looking like. On Friday, they'll be taking on Jonas Valanciunas and the Los Angeles Clippers. Then on Sunday, they'll face off against Ben Simmons and the Golden State Warriors.
And looking at the Philadelphia matchup, you know they're going to want to make a statement in that contest. Taking down the top team in the East could definitely turn some heads.
That one misses.
Two possession game now, but he'd still like to have back that one he missed.
Now here's Okoro, covered by MP. Let's it go with a three. And it's Phoenix with the rebound. Ayton's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. On the wing, MP. Ayton sets the pick for MP. Here he goes. And Okoro pulls it down.
Teammates right now covering up for the type of off performance he's having. In terms of scoring, this has not been his best night. Wouldn't surprise me to see him find his touch and still be a factor. Don't count them out yet.
Now MP. Following the 3-point attempt by Donovan Mitchell. MP no good. The Cavaliers trail by 5. Mitchell passes to Mamu Kalashvili, and it's good, 2 points. Mamu Kalashvili has got his first points in this one, and the Suns call time here. Here. first quarter of play, about 2 minutes in now. And here is MP. MP finds a gap. Banked in off the glass. And the Suns lead by five.
And cutting to the rim with assertiveness, MP has no problems taking charge.
To the inside, Garland, and he floats in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Seems to be nobody standing in his way. No roadblocks for him to get to his spot, capitalize, and continue to be aggressive.
There's the triple from Durant.
And Durant, the purest shooters in the league.
The Cavaliers trail by six. Here's Garland. Minute of action now gone here in the fourth.
Good. Nice job down low.
And Garland stepping up to knock one down.
Now MP. And there's the drive. Jared Allen grabs the miss. Allen's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Akuro's shot is off.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look.
Nice ball movement by Phoenix. Offensive rebound. 2 points. That one goes. Great game for him. Double-double now. 11 points and 10 rebounds. Mitchell against Beal. Mitchell kicks to Okoro. Good, and it's Mitchell picking up the assist. Mitchell's got his 3rd assist on the night. MP against Garland. KD passes to Harrington. MP against Garland. Here's Fleming. That one, no good. Garland with the defensive effort. The Cavaliers trail by 3. Mitchell left side. And it's Durant with the rebound. And KD's got the ball here for the Phoenix Suns. MP outside. The drive. It's in!
And when they need it most, the team knows they can count on MP in any situation.
And the Cavaliers call time here. They're trailing by 5. There's 39 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what do you think?
And they need to use as little time as possible here. If they can get a bucket before the clock hits 24 seconds, they can try for a stop on the next possession. If there's less than 24, then they'll have to foul.
And now the latest from our reporter, David Alden.
Hey, Kevin, thanks. During that last break, I listened in to J.B. Bickerstaff's huddle. I begged his players to keep it simple out there. Told them one possession at a time. Don't look at the scoreboard. What's most important is running our plays and being aggressive defensively. We'll see if they can follow that game plan. Guys?
Thanks so much, David. A bucket here would give them a bit more room.
True, but no need to rush it. Play smart.
At just about 7 feet, Jared Allen can be imposing as a defensive presence.
Mitchell right side. Good! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
And such a clutch shooter. I mean, he lives with a big shot. And when he's rolling like this, watch out.
So they foul intentionally.
That's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
At the line for your Suns, MP. 2 shots.
And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to fall.
Well, MP is up against it here. Time to push out all distractions and just focus on his finish.
Timeout called, Cleveland. They're behind by 3. 17 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what's your take?
And if you can get a 3, shoot it. Otherwise, get the quick 2 and a foul.
Don't force something up. You got to be smart here.
Mitchell in the corner, shoots, and it's Phoenix with the rebound. They foul intentionally. That's what they have to do at this point.
Third personal foul. Fourth team foul. At the line for your Suns, DeAndre Ayton. Two shots.
He hits the first one, and that gives them a four-point cushion.
A solid free throw shooter. Let's see if Ayton can capitalize at the line. This game is close.
And he is unable to get the second one. And here's Mitchell from the arc. MB grabs the miss. And now an intentional foul. They need the ball back as soon as possible.
First personal foul. 15 foul.
At the line for Phoenix.
Good on the first, and that puts them up by five. Second free throw, no good that time. He really wanted that one. And Allen launches it from deep. Misses. So the Suns win it. They didn't make it easy on themselves or their fans. But in the end, everyone satisfied.
I mean, there were some times that momentum shifted, and especially early on. But let's give this group a lot of credit for that stick-to-itiveness in terms of finishing out and executing that game plan.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. So for David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, Brent Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. So long, everyone.
Nice team win. Let's keep it going. I'm going to Denver for the first time.
It's going to be fun watching tape on this one, huh?
Okay. That's what I'm saying. This kind of approach takes total commitment.
If you get frustrated and switch it up, you'll lose whatever gains you made, right?
Yeah, you've been chipping away at it, though. Doing something new every time I see you play. Both sides of the ball.
What you said last time spoke to me, bro. If I want to be an all-time great, I got to dominate every aspect of the game.
You just got to keep working, man. You're on your way.
That means a lot to me, man. For real. Thank you.
Yeah.